살다 보니 이런 날이 다 있네.
Yes. This is a crazy fucking movie. And I saw this at the IFC Theater the day I did an SNL episode, and the next day I went to IFC Theater at midnight and watched this movie. Oh. This is how much I like that movie.
Let me just say, spoiler alert, somebody turns from a dude into a pile of bananas wearing a hat in it, and it makes logical sense. At that point in the movie, you're like,
okay,
yeah, that's what should happen to that guy.
Nike Orpheus, which I adore, the red shoes, 400 blows,
mm-hmm.
fantastic, and oh dear lord, charade.
I haven't even looked back here. I can't take all of this. Is like, how do you choose? Repulsion.
Even though it's a very constructed film, it's a very remarkable film. And of course, apart from anything else, we were all at the time, us lads, deeply in love with Anna Karina. There she is. Good. So that's very important. Important aspect of films.
A woman is a woman. Well, it's a film that by Jean-Luc Godard with Jean-Paul Belmondo, Jean-Claude Boyali, and me, Anna Karina.
I saw a weekend of Godard with my mother, and I was enraged by it. And I said, this is the most horrible thing that I've ever seen. I hate it. And over the course of maybe 2 days, it sank in on me. And I then decided that it was like my favorite movie that I'd ever seen in my life.
And it was prophetic. Yes, it was prophetic.
It was a great, great film. And and it was a big shock to me that that could happen.
That's Made in USA. Well, yeah, that's me.
미디엄 쿨은 제가 옛날에 DVD를 가지고 있었는데 박찬욱 감독님이 이걸 빌려가서 먹어버렸어요. 안 돌려줬어요.
Once at a screening down in Los Angeles, I came late and I walked into the screening room and I stepped on somebody's toe and I sat down next to him. And just as the film was beginning, somebody came in front of us and the man next to me said, "Hello, Fritz." And Fritz Lang turned around and said, "Hello, Jean." And I was sitting next to Jean Renoir with Fritz Lang sitting in front of me.
I picked another one. Oh, I know, of course, Beyond the Valley of the Dolls. I might even be in this. But it's such a good present to give everybody. This movie's like a fine wine. It gets better and better as life goes on.
Some friends of mine asked me for a film recommendation. I said, watch Close Up, like there's no way you won't have a great time. And they were like, no, we did, kind of like, it wasn't the right vibe. But anyway, it's an incredible film.
When I was a kid and I only had a black and white TV, so certain scenes of it were completely lost on me. And I remember going to school the next day and going, yeah, Rumblefish was brilliant. And they go, yeah, the bit with the goldfish, the Rumblefish was amazing. I'm like, no, I don't know, was it? Yeah, so now I'll finally be able to see it with that tiny bit of colour in it, so that's exciting.
Zazie Don the Metro was with Persona, my favourite film. This is, like, I watched this probably every month, this film, embarrassingly.
There was a screening of Red Desert, which is maybe my favourite of his films. A director's cut at MoMA, and somebody took us as a surprise and didn't tell us where we were going, because Antonioni is Cindy, my wife's favorite filmmaker. And there were these little tables we sat at for dinner after the screening of the film, and strangely enough, Antonioni was at the next table and sitting all by himself. Everybody had left him, either because he only spoke Italian or French. And I went and sat next to him and said, introduced myself, and I said, this must be an amazing night for you. And he said, oh, no, no, I hate it tonight. I said, why? He said, there are 14 frames in the film that I can't stand. And every time I see the film, it breaks my heart that I can't do those over again.
That's the tragedy of film.
They're great films, inspire me and all of us to get started, but as you get on a little bit, you're looking for, you know, what is it that gets you out of bed in the morning that says, I saw a great movie last night, and it's all worthwhile.
There's never been a movie like this, Dr. Strangelove. I play this game. If there was a day and all your favorite filmmakers were opening a movie on that day, which filmmaker's movie would you see first? That tells you something, right? For me, it's this guy.
Surrounded by all of these riches, all of the great history of international film, this is the one for me. This is one of my favorite films ever, and I'm not even going to look for any more past this, because just to walk out of this building with this film on Blu-ray makes my day, my week, possibly my year. Thanks to Criterion, and thanks to Federico Fellini for one of the greatest film experiences I've ever had.
All right, that's it, I'm done. I'm not taking any more. Okay, I'm only taking one more. Okay, now I'm done, all right? This is embarrassing. This is really embarrassing.
Okay, thanks a lot.
It's a very small robbery.
Okay, let's go, we leave. We have to stop. Open the door.